Today, now we shall now enter into lesson number 5. Though we have learned the Subhashitani for memorization, but now let us start understanding the meanings of these Subhashitani. In today's class, we shall learn what is a Subhashitam and the 11 Subhashitas that we have learned so far. Let us try to understand their simple first level of meaning and also how to write in the exam as well. Prathamataya Subhashitam Namakim. What is Subhashitam? Sushtu Bhashitam iti Subhashitam iti Vaktum Shakyate. One which has been said very well can be called a Subhashitam. What are these? What are these Subhashitam, if you ask a question? Subhashitam is nothing but a very good saying, a proverb, a shloka which has a moral in it, which has a few examples of how one should behave or how one should live, and also a few examples of how one should not conduct himself. So all these things which help us to understand what is good, to help us improve ourselves, and which will also tell what is the right thing to do and what is not correct, etc. These sayings, these good sayings, the proverbs, etc. are called Subhashitam or Subhashitani. Subhashitam is Napumsakalinga Shabda, and hence the plural form will be Subhashitani. Okay, now let us go to each of the Subhashitam one by one. We shall understand the meaning with respect to that. Okay.
Nasti vidya samo bandhuho, nasti sat satya samam tapaha, nasti rag samam dukham, nasti satyag samam sukham.
Dhanyavada. Few important corrections that you need to make is because of your Hindi accent maybe or reading of Hindi, rag samam you say, but it is raga samam. In Sanskritam, unless we put a halant, that is this mark below that particular vyanjanam, it is recited in full only. Raga samam, sukham.
Raga samam.
Yes. Similarly, tyaga samam.
Tyaga samam.
Yes.
Okay. Thank you.
Otherwise, well recited. Dhanyavada. Adhuna asya subhashitasya artham jani maha. Let us now try to understand the meaning of this shloka or this subhashitam. If you see in all these four padas, the four quarters of this subhashitam, some of the words are repeating. Nasti is there everywhere. Samaha or samam is there everywhere. Now, what is that we are trying to convey out of this subhashitam? There are these words which are there here, samaha, then you have one word and there is one more word. You are trying to relate between these two, saying that there is no other relative, bandhuhu means relative, than vidya. Nasti means not there. Samaha means equal to, which is equal to or equivalent to, etc. Samaha means equal, nasti means not there. So the first line, the first pada will say, there is no relative which is equal to vidya, or vidya is the most required relative. Okay. So that is the knowledge is what is very much useful. Similarly, if you go to the second pada, again, nasti, same meaning. There is no. Tapaha. Tapaha means penance. We know rishis or sages used to do lot of penance, lot of tapas. But in today's world, for us, for anyone, what is the greatest tapas? Or there is no tapas which is equivalent to the truth. We should be always truthful to ourselves and to others. So being truthful, or the truth itself, is following this itself is a tapas. We can take example of Harishchandra, Raja Harishchandra, who always spoke the truth. And for that, he had to face lot of obstacles, lot of hurdles. And he overcame all those because of his sincerity and his truth. So there is nothing else, or there is no other tapaha, there is no other penance which is equivalent to that of truth. Now, the next line, similarly, nasti raga samam dukham. Dukham means sorrow. Ragaha means desire or likingness. Okay, so or attachment. You can also increase this meaning or the width or the span of this word into attachment as well. So raga samam, the sorrow is all created because of our attachments, because of our expectations, because of our desires, etc. So there is no other dukkha, there is no other sorrow which is equivalent to raga. Okay, so that is the desire. So that is the meaning of this line. Next, the last one, nasti tyaga samam sukham. What is sukham? What is the happiness? That is nothing but the tyaga. Tyaga is giving up, giving up or the renunciation. So tyaga samam sukham nasti. So if you see this, you can also correlate this to sannyasa. Nyasa means giving up or leaving, actually. So that which is done with as part of a samskara, which is a part of a process, etc., will become a sannyasa. So there everything is given up, everything is given up. But that means to say, what is given up is not that you will not do anything, etc., or anything like that, but the phala that you associate with every action of yours, you give up all those things. That is karma sannyasa, and so on. So there is no other happiness than giving up. So this Subhashitam tells us that for us to live a very happy life, what is that we should do is, first is vidyarjanam. We need to earn, or we need to learn a lot. We need to gain knowledge. And then we need to be truthful. We should speak always the truth. And then we should not develop this quality of attachment or desire. And we should be ready to give up anything for these causes. So this is what this Subhashitam means. So the general meaning of this Subhashitam and the how we will have to write in the exam, if you ask. So first is, we will have to write the Anvaya. Anvaya means it is called the prose order. As you know, in Sanskritam, the order of the words will not matter. Instead of saying nasti vidya samaha bandhuhu, I can also say nasti bandhuhu vidya samaha, or vidya samaha bandhuhu nasti. You can shuffle the words across, and but still the meaning of the Subhashitam or the meaning of the sentences will be the same. Now, to understand the meaning in a better format, in a better way, what we'll have to do is we'll have to rearrange these words so that the Kriyapadam will be put at the last. Kriyapadam will be put at the end. Vidyasamaha bandhuhu nasti. If you reword this, or basically to rearrange these words, then the meaning will be made out easily. So that is called Anvaya. Anvaya is called prose order. You will rearrange these words, whatever is there in the Subhashitam, and then you will write it. That is called Anvaya. And next is Padapadartha. Padapadartha is nothing but meaning for each of the word, like how I have shown in this right side of the slide. Samaha means equal, then nasti means not there, vidya means knowledge, bandhuhu means relative. So for each word you write the meaning. This is called padapadartha. The next concept is bhavartha. Bhavartha is nothing but the summary meaning of this Subhashitam. Okay, that is the bhavartha, which is there is no relative that is equal to with the knowledge. There is no penance that is equal to truth. There is no sorrow that is equal to desire. And there is no happiness that is equal to renunciation. So this summary, what you write, that is called the bhavartha. Okay. So in the exam, the questions will be, they would give a particular Subhashitam, any one of the Subhashitam, and ask you to write the Anvaya order and the bhavartha. Okay. So that is what we will have to practice writing as well. So we shall now go to the next Subhashitam.
Nabhaso bhushanam chandraha narinam bhushanam patihi prithivya bhushanam raja vidya sarvasya bhushanam.
Uttamam, dhanyavadaha. So only one place, narinam, nakara did not, I couldn't hear the nakara correctly. But otherwise, well recited. Okay. Now, in this Subhashitam, again, we can see some common word which is there everywhere in all the four padas. Bhushanam, Bhushanam, Bhushanam. Bhushanam means what? Bhushanam means ornament. Whichever is being, whichever makes something adorable, more beautiful, okay, which beautifies something, that is an ornament. Ornament, basically Abharanam also we can say, but it is nothing but to enhance the beauty of some object. Now, what are these? So now if you compare, now we have understood the meaning of this word, Bhushanam. Bhushanam means ornament. Now we also see some more words in this Subhashitam, which is all in Prathama Vibhakti. Okay, which I am underlining right now. Chandraha, Patihi, Raja, Vidya. These four words in the Subhashitam are in Prathama Vibhakti. So the ornament is Chandraha. The ornament is Patihi. The ornament is Raja. The ornament is Vidya. Now, if you ask a question, what Chandra is the ornament, but of what? Chandra is the ornament for whom or of what? If you ask a question, then you will get the answer Nabhasaha. And then similarly, Patihi, Kasya Bhushanam, whose ornament is Apati? If you ask, then the answer will be in again Shashti Vibhakti. Kasya, again, as I said, it's a general question. Kasya Bhushanam, Narinam Bhushanam, Narinam, Nari, Ikaranta, Strilinga Shabda. If you remember today, Nadi Naam, we have seen. Similarly, Nari Naam. Okay. Next, Raja Kasya Bhushanam or Kasyaha Bhushanam, Prithivyaha. So there is a Visarga here, Prithivyaha, but based on the Sandhi rules, the Visarga will be eliminated. Okay. But when we write answers, etc., we will have to remember this. Next, Vidya Kasya Bhushanam, Sarvasya Bhushanam. Vidya is the ornament of everyone. Okay. Now let us see the Palapadartha. Nabhaha means sky. Nabhasaha. Nabhas is a different shabda that we haven't seen actually. It is a sakaranta shabda and hence the form is nabhasaha. So here again, based on sandhi rules, this nabhaso it has become. This is also a visarga sandhi which is not part of Prathama syllabus and hence we will not be covering more related to visarga sandhi. Other sandhis are there which we shall take up in the next class. So nabhasaha bhushanam basically. Okay. Not Nabhasoho, it is Nabhasaha Bhushanam. It becomes Nabhasoho Bhushanam. Next, similarly, Nari means woman. The ornament for any woman is basically husband. So, Bhushanam Patihi. And similarly, Prithivyaha Bhushanam. Prithivi means earth of this Bhumi. That is why, if you remember, Bhupatihi means king. Okay, he is the king, is the ornament or one who adorns this Bhumi. And similarly, the last one, Sarvasya, of everything. Vidya is the Bhushanam of everything or everyone. For everyone, the Vidya is the Bhushanam. Vidya is the ornament. Okay. So, in all these things, so one thing that we should remember is in which Vibhakti each of these words are occurring. In which Vibhakti each of these words are occurring. So, here it is again, all these words are Shashti Vibhaktihi. It is denoting the relation. Chandra is the ornament of Nabhaha, which is sky, of Nari, of Prithivi, and of everyone or of everything. So this is in Shashti Vibhaktihi. Okay, similar to Ramasya, Tasya, and all the other words, Vidya, Bhushanam, etc. are in Prathama Vibhaktihi. Please make a note of this and we shall proceed further to the next Subhashitam.
सुखस्यानन्तरं दुःखं दुःखस्यानन्तरं सुखं चक्रवत् परिवर्तन्ते दुःखानि च सुखानि च
उत्तमं धन्यवादाः महोदय वेल रिसाइटेड सो आई शल आस्क अ फ्यू क्वेश्चंस नाउ यू कैन ट्राई टू आंसर देम एंड लेट अस सी ओके सो इन दिस इफ यू सी देयर इज अगेन वन वर्ड इज रिपीटिंग हियर अनंतरम एंड अनंतरम So what is the meaning of anantaram?
Yeah, anantaram basically means part of it. It's a you're comparing it.
Okay, it is not comparison. Okay, but anantaram is after. Okay, anantaram.
Okay, anantaram, yeah, after, okay, right. It follows basically.
Something which follows immediately after, or something which follows. Yes, that is right.
Yes.
So in the first line, we are seeing two words again, sukhasya and then dukkham. And similarly, in the second line, we are seeing dukkhasya and then sukham. Okay, so now what does it mean? Sukhasya anantaram dukkham. Yeah, can you tell that now?
Yeah. The sukha or the happiness is always followed by a sorrow, and similarly sorrow is always followed by a happiness.
Yes, dhanyavadaha. So dukkham is again here, it is prathama bhaktihi. Dukkham is followed immediately after sukha. Sukhasya anantaram, after sukha or after happiness, then the dukkham, the sorrow, is immediately followed. And similarly, it is the same way around. The happiness is again followed after the dukkham or after the sorrow. That is what it means. Sukham, happiness, dukkham, sorrow. Next, how does it happen? How does it happen if you ask a question? Then the answer will be chakravata. Chakravata. Chakram means what?
Wheel.
Yes.
Or it's a cycle.
Basically, chakravat is like a wheel. Parivartante. Parivartante means these keep on revolving,
keep on changing.
Actually, dukkhani cha sukhani cha, both this sorrow and happiness keep going round and round, or keep repeating one after the other, like in a wheel. Okay, the wheel of fortune, we can call it as. So this subhashitam gives the essence of life. So most of the times when we are really happy, we will go on to the cloud nine. We will be so much happy that it will be seen, and everyone around will think, okay, what happened, or why are you so happy, etc., right? But then if we are a bit even sorrow, or if we are facing a bit of challenges, etc., we fall down. We completely think that we have gone underground or something like that. So that is the sukha and dukkha, and the way we express it. So what Gitacharya Krishna says is sukha dukkhe same kritva, right? So labha labhau jaya jaya. In the same way, this sukha and dukkha, this happiness and sorrow, will keep on coming. It is like changing every now and then, like a wheel. How a particular spot on a wheel goes up and down, in the same way is also in our life. It is full of ups and downs. So hence, we shouldn't be really worried about either sukha or dukkha. We should treat it equally. That is what the essence of life, this subhashitam, is trying to give us. Hope this is understood. Sukhasya anantaram. There is a sandhi here, which is savarna dirgha sandhi. Sukhasya plus anantaram, it becomes sukhasya anantaram. Whenever we have so two words in a sandhi, basically it is a combination of two words. The ending word has akara or akara. Similarly, the next word, the second word, it starts with akara or akara, or similar swara. Similar to, it can be ikara or ikara, and both the words should have the same thing. The ending letter of the first word, the starting letter of the second word. These two should be either a or a, e or e, u or u, the same combination. In such case, what will happen? When you combine these words, a dirgha will come here. So similar to devalayaha, deva alayaha, then sukhasya anantaram. Okay, this is adirgha is replacing these two letters, and hence this is called savarna dirgha sandhi. Savarna means similar, dirgha means the result of it, and because of the sandhi. So just know this today. In the upcoming class, we shall definitely learn more about the sandhi aspects. Okay, similarly dukhasya anantaram. You can split it here. Dukkhasya anantaram sukham. Chakravat parivartante. These will be revolving or changing like a wheel. And the sukhani cha dukkhani cha. Sukham and dukkham are both napumsakalinga shabdas. And hence this is in bahuvachana. Prathama vibhaktihi bahuvachana. We shall proceed further to the next subhashitam.
Narasyabharanam rupam. Rupasyabharanam gunaha, gunasyabharanam gnanam, gnanasyabharanam kshama.
Uttamam, dhanyavadaha. So, can you split this word, narasyabharanam? Based on based on what we learned in the previous slide, where it was dukkhasya anantaram, sukhasya anantaram, sukhasya anantaram. The same way, how to split this?
Narasya abharanam.
Very good. Narasya abharanam rupam. Similarly, the second line.
Rupasya abharanam.
Okay. Third line.
Gunasya abharanam.
Last one.
Gnanasya abharanam.
Very good. Now, if you remember, Nabhaso Bhushanam Chandraha from that Subhashitam, it is very similar to that in this. So, Abharanam also means ornament. Bhushanam also means ornament. Okay, it is Abharanam, not Abharanam, Abharanam. Okay, Narasya Abharanam Rupam. Narasya Abharanam Kim, what is the Abharanam, what is the Bhushanam of Nara? Naraha means?
Narasya Abharanam Rupam.
Very good. Abharanam means ornament. Narasya of man. So don't think it's only for men and not for women. So it's a collective noun. So when we say man, it means to say for the whole of the mankind. Okay. So Narasya Abharanam Rupam. Okay. Rupam means beauty. That is the Abharanam that anyone can have. Okay. Next, second one. Rupasya Abharanam Kimasti.
Rupasya
Abharanam Gunaha.
Very good. Rupasya Abharanam Gunaha. The ornament of Rupa is nothing but the quality, the good quality or good conduct, etc. Okay, next. Gunasya Abharanam Kim?
Gunasya Abharanam Gnanam.
Very good. Gunasya Abharanam Gnanam. The quality, the ornament for the quality is nothing but the knowledge. Okay, next. Gnanasya Abharanam Kim?
Gnanasya
Abharanam Kshama.
Gnanasya Abharanam Kshama. Kshama is basically patience, forgiveness, compassion, etc. All these words mean kshama. So this is a chain, if you remember. So Narasya Abharanam Rupam. So if you think that Narasya Abharanam is Rupam, but then Rupasya Abharanam Kim? Rupasya Abharanam Gunaha. Gunasya Abharanam Kim? Jnanam. Jnanasya Abharanam Kim? It is kshama. So this means to say, if only he is very beautiful, okay, if a person is very beautiful, he will be very much arrogant about that, or he will be proud about that. Okay, it may be also vanity. Okay, so but that alone is not sufficient or does not end there. Okay, so what is that? It is required that particular, if he is good looking, that means to say he is good, he should also have equal and good qualities. That is not sufficient still. If he has good qualities also along with that, if he is knowledgeable, only then that is the real abharanam, or that is the real ornament that he is wearing. And but if just the knowledge is there, but the arrogance, no, again, it is not the case. So the knowledge, which is also combined with patience, forgiveness and compassion, that is the real abharanam. So this helps us understand, if we have Rupa, but we don't have Guna, then it's of no use. Or if we have Rupa and Guna, or just Guna, but if we don't have knowledge, then that also it's of no use. Or if we just have knowledge, but we don't have the humility or the patience or the forgiveness, then again, it's of no use. So at the end, this to complete the cycle of being good or reaching a state that someone says he's really a good person, then we should have all these four qualities. Of course, Rupam is that we see, we can see it through our eyes. But that again is not a hurdle for achieving the other three important things, which is Guna, Jnana and Kshama, which is all the internal qualities of any person. These are also called Atma Gunaha. Okay, so that is the Subhashitam, the meaning of this Subhashitam. We shall now proceed to the next Subhashitam.
विदेशेषु धनं विद्या व्यसनेषु धनं मतिः परलोके धनं धर्मः शीलं सर्वत्र वैधनम्
उत्तमम्. So now let us try to identify various vibhaktis in this. Videsheshu, vyasaneshu, can you tell which vibhakti is this in?
Saptami.
Very good. Saptami vibhaktihi, which vachana?
Bahuvachana. 7.3.
Yes, very good. This also is similar. So I'm directly taking. Okay, paraloke.
7.1.
Very good. दिस एकवचनम सप्तमे विभक्ति ही एकवचन धनम
धनम इसी द्वितीय
द्वितीय विभक्ति 2.1 इसी द्वितीय और इट इज प्रथमा विभक्ति
नपुंसकलिकम प्रथमा विभक्ति
It is Prathama Vibhakti. Okay, so the forms are both. It is both in Prathama and Dvitiya Vibhakti. What it is referring to, when we understand the meaning, it will be clear.
Okay.
So it is in Prathama Vibhakti. Okay, now, if you see the last set of words, Vidya, Matihi, Dharmaha, Dhanam, or Shilam, basically. These are all in, again, Prathama Vibhakti, Ekavachanam. All these words are in Prathama Vibhakti, Ekavachanam. Similar to the previous shlokas of Subhashitani, a particular word is repeating. Dhanam, 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 similar to Abharanam, Bhushanam, etc. Videsheshu dhanam, in Videshaha means what? Foreign, in foreign countries, okay? Dhanam is nothing but what is the wealth? If you are going, if you are traveling, etc., the real wealth is nothing but the knowledge. Knowledge is the real wealth. Videsheshu dhanam vidya. So if you have money, that alone is not sufficient. If you want to survive elsewhere, then that means to say we should be knowledgeable. Okay. Similarly, vyasaneshu dhanam. What is the wealth with respect to the vyasana? What is the meaning of vyasana? I shall show. Vyasana means it is difficulty. In the difficulty, at difficult situations, what is the real wealth that anyone can possess? It is nothing but the matihi or the intelligence or the mind. Similarly, paraloke in a different loka, which is after this world, then. What is the dhanam? What is that wealth? That wealth is nothing but dharmaha. That is the dharma or the righteousness that we have followed in this present life. And next, what is the wealth of everything? Shilam, that is the good conduct. Good conduct is the wealth everywhere, okay? Of everything and of everywhere, okay? Sarvatra means everywhere, okay? This is an avyaya. This is also an avyaya, atra, tatra, sarvatra, etc. These are all avyayas which denote the place. Sarvatra means everywhere. Okay. So this is the meaning of this Subhashitam. So what it actually means, there's also a saying in English, right? So with respect to the good conduct. So if character is lost, everything is lost, right? So that the character is very important. The shilam or basically the good conduct is very important, which is the wealth wherever you go. Okay. So this means to say dhanam, what we associate with wealth, which with the materialistic wealth, maybe money or home or property, etc., is nothing. But those will be of no use unless these are there at the required times. Especially in this pandemic time, because of so much of difficulty everywhere, it is our mind. If you are strong mentally and emotionally, then half the hurdle is crossed, or at least we will be in a position to make our living, etc. But if that is not the case, then it would have been very difficult, right? So that is why vyasaneshu dhanam matihi. Vyasanam means at difficult times, our matihi, our mind or our intellect, mental health as well as the emotional health, the intellect, this has to be safeguarded very well. And that whatever we have, that because of that, we will also be better. So this is the meaning of overall meaning of this Subhashitam. So videsheshu dhanam vidya. So in foreign countries, the wealth is nothing but the knowledge. Similarly, at difficult times, it is the intellect. And in the other world, it is the dharma, the righteous path. And then at everywhere or at every place, it is the good conduct. Now we shall go to the next Subhashitam.
Pradoshe deepakachandraha prabhate deepako ravihi. त्रैलोके दीपको धर्मः सुपुत्थ कुलदीपकः
उत्तमम् विल रिसाइटेड ओनली वन पॉइंट दीपकश चंद्रः देयर आई थिंक यू मेड अ मिस्टेक एंड सुपुत्रः कुलदीपकः देयर इज नो महाप्राण और मोर स्ट्रेस सुपुत्रः कुलदीपकः इज सफिशिएंट
धन्यवाद
प्रदोषे व्हिच विभक्ति इट इज
सप्तमी एकवचनं महोदय
सप्तमी एकवचनं वेरी गुड सिमिलरली प्रभाते
प्रभाते सप्तमी सप्तमी एकवचनम
वेरी गुड देन त्रैलोक्ये
सप्तमी
एकवचनम सप्तमी एकवचनम
वेरी गुड नेक्स्ट सुपुत्र ओके एनीवे देयर इज नो Next, Deepakaha. This is split as Deepakaha Chandraha. Don't worry, again, this is a Visarga Sandhi. Deepakaha Chandraha, it becomes Deepakash Chandraha. Again, here also Visarga Sandhi, Deepakaha Ravihi. Okay. And similarly, here also Deepakaha Dharmaha and Kula Deepakaha. Okay. Now, let us try to understand. Chandraha means moon and Deepakaha means lamp or light. Okay. What is the light during the darkness or during the evenings? Okay. Pradoshaha means night. During the night, what is the light that we can see? That is Chandraha. In the same way, Deepakaha is again light. Ravihi means sun. Prabhate means morning. What can be the meaning of the second line?
Daytime.
During daytime.
Deepako Ravihi. During daytime, the light is sun.
Very good. During night, the light is Chandra. During daytime, it is Ravihi. Ravihi means sun. Very good. Prabhatam means morning.
Morning.
Okay. It is a Napumsakalinga Shabda. Prabhatam. So, Prabhate, however, it is similar to Vanam Vane. So, Saptami Bhakti is Vane. Okay. Next, similarly, Trailokya Deepako Dharmaha. What is the meaning?
In the other word, Dharma is a light.
Very good. In all the three
words. All three words.
Very good. Trailokya. Trailokya means in all the three words. Okay. Trailokya means it is combination of all the three words. In all three words, the Dharma is the light. Okay. So, and last part, which is Kula Deepakaha. Suputraha Kula Deepakaha.
But good son.
Good son.
Good son is a
Kulasya Deepakaha.
Light for the family.
For family is light.
Yes. Family is light. Kulasya Deepakaha. Here, if you, this is Samasa word, basically Samasta Padam. So, this is Samasa, compound word. How do we split it is Kulasya Deepakaha. Okay, I will not take more time or explain more details with respect to Samasa because it is beyond the scope of this course. But to understand the meaning, it is the Kulasya Deepakaha of the family, light of the family. So, Dhanyavadaha Sarvebhyaha, you participated well. So, what this Subhashita means is there are different light or torch bearers at different situations. What are those? The first one, during the night, it is Chandra, Surya, and then Dharma, which is the conduct. In all the three worlds, but a Suputraha, a good son, is the torch bearer or he is the light of the family. So he will be making the family also to shine. That's what it means. Okay. So let us remember all these and we'll go ahead. The next one.
Lalaye Panja Varshani. दशवर्षाणि ताडयेत् प्राप्ते तु षोडशे वर्षे पुत्रं मित्रवदाचरेत्
उत्तमं धन्यवादः वेल रिसाइटेड ओके नाउ लालयेत् एंड ओके इफ यू आइडेंटिफाई हियर इन दिस सुभाषितम दीस आर द क्रियापदास लालयेत् ताडयेत् देन आचरेत् ओके कैन एनीवन स्प्लिट दिस वर्ड The last word?
Mitravat Acharet.
Very good. It is Mitravat Acharet. Okay. It is not Mitravada Acharet or something like that. It is not a Savarna Dirgha Sandhi. There is no Sandhi at all in this word. So it is Mitravat Acharet. It is just a Gunitaksharam. Okay. Good. So Lalayet, Tadayet, Acharet. These three are the Kriyapadas in this sentence, Tingantams basically, which is Vidhiling Lakara. Okay, which is Vidhiling Lakara. If you remember, Vidhiling is to order or this must be done in this way, etc. To say that. Okay, now let us try to understand. There are some numbers in this Subhashitam. Can you identify them?
Pancha, Dasha, Shodasha.
Okay, Pancha, Dasha and Shodasha. Okay, so Pancha, 5. Can you tell the other numbers?
Dasha is 10, Shodasha is 16.
Very good. 16. Okay. Very good. Now, Varshani is there. Varshani means years, basically. Yes. At the age of, yes. Or at the years, at so much year, etc. And then, Varshe and Prapte. This we will see. Prapte is in which Vibhakti?
Saptami Prathami.
Okay. Very good. Saptami Vibhakti hi Ekavachanam. Similarly, Varshe is also. सप्तमी विभक्ति ही एकवचनम ओके आई शिल एक्सप्लेन अबाउट इट इन सम टाइम ओके देन पुत्रम विच विभक्ति
द्वितीय विभक्ति
वेरी गुड इट इज पुत्रम इज द्वितीय विभक्ति ही पुत्रः इज द पुल्लिंग शब्द पुत्रम इज द्वितीय विभक्ति ही द्वितीय विभक्ति ही एकवचनम नेक्स्ट लास्ट वन मित्रवत एनीवे डोंट वरी अबाउट ओके सो दीस आर द identifications that we have done so far. Now, for up to 5 years, so here in this, the Subhashitakara is giving or telling that how you should conduct yourself with your children, basically. Here, putram means it's not just putram, it's also applicable to putri. Okay. So first thing is lalayet. So should be affectionate towards your kids. Up to what time? Up to what age? Up to 5 years only. Okay, Varsham means year, up to 5 years of your kid, the first 5 years, you should be so much affectionate towards them. You should show and shower so much of love towards them. And after that, after the 5th year, Dasha Varshani, the next 10 years, you should be strict. Okay, you should beat them. Beat them in a sense, it is not without any reason, but of course, you should be strict with them. So if they do some mistake, if they commit some mistake, immediately you should punish them so that they won't repeat those mistakes again. Now 5 years are over and next 10 years are over, which becomes 15 years. So prapte tu shodashe varshe, when the kid or when the child has reached or has attained 16 years, okay, at that point in time prapte tu shodashe varshe. This specific line is a very important prayoga in Sanskritam, which is called sati saptami. Okay, it is called sati saptami. Don't worry about it, it's a technical term. So we are using saptami vibhakti in multiple words. Prapte tu shodashe varshe, that means to say when this is achieved or when this is reached at that point in time. So that is what it means basically. So once the child has become 16 year old, then putram mitravat acharet. Mitravat means like a friend. Treat your children like friends, basically. So this is how we should treat our children. That is the meaning of this Subhashitam. I hope you are all able to understand it. Okay. So putram mitravat acharit. So from then on, from 16th year onwards, treat him as a friend. Okay. Now let us go to the next Subhashitam.
स्वगृहे पूज्यते मूर्खः स्वग्रामे पूज्यते प्रभुः स्वदेशे पूज्यते राजा विद्वान् सर्वत्र पूज्यते
सो लेट अस ट्राई टू आइडेंटिफाई सिमिलरली इन द प्रीवियस क्वेश्चंस व्हिच आर ऑल द वर्ड्स इन सप्तमी विभक्ति इन दिस
स्वगृहे स्वग्रामे स्वदेशे
वेरी गुड ऑल दीस वर्ड्स which are there here are saptami vibhakti swagrihe swagrame and swadeshe next
saptami
the can you identify the kriya padam
pujyate
pujyate
pujyate pujyate is the kriya padam can you I also identify which padi it is whether it is
atmane padi
yes atmane padi very good Atmanepadi and next can you also identify which purusha and vachana
pujyate ekavachanam
very good
prathama
purusha ekavachanam purusha sevate sevite sevante pujyate
pujyante
very good next murkha prabhu raja vidwan all prathama bhakti okay
ekavachanam
you have not seen anyway prathama vibhakti ekavachanam vidvan shabd basically it is vidwan means a knowledgeable person what is the meaning of this so this kind of kriya pada we hadn't seen so pujyate means will be worshipped by okay so this is in a passive voice basically whenever we tell a kriya padam in atmanepadi which has a yakara in it for example pathyate okay or anything like that okay so in such cases it is the passive voice in it is there. Strihe is also in the similar way a murkha, a person, a dumb person, or one who is not intelligent enough, okay, he is worshipped or he is respected only in his own home. Swagrihe, swasya griham, okay, one's own home. Swagrihe pujyate murkha, a fool is worshipped in his own home. That's it. So he'll not get any respect once he comes out of his house. In the same way, Prabhu, what do you mean by Prabhu?
Raja.
Raja, samichinam. Prabhu means Raja, or a mighty person, or a rich person, basically of a particular village. Okay. So Swagrame, he will be respected only in his own village or in his own town. Okay. Swagrame only. Swasya Gramaha, Swagramaha, Swagrame. Next, similarly, a Raja. Raja is the king of a country. Okay. Raja is the king of a country. Swadeshe Pujyate. He will be only worshipped by all other people, okay, by people in his own country. And next, but what about the Vidwan, a learned person? Vidwan Sarvatra Pujyate. He is being worshipped at every place or everywhere. Okay. So what it means again, the jnanam, the knowledge is something that is very important, and because of knowledge, you can command respect at every place or at any place that you go. So that is the meaning of this Subhashita. Okay, I hope this is understood. So Swagrame Pujyate Prabhu, only, say for example, you can think it as village panchayat or something. He is a person in the panchayat. So he'll be respected only in that particular grama. But if he goes to a different village, then obviously there will be one more person equivalent to him, and people will respect the leader of that village and not the leader from the other village. So this is showing where our respect, or what is the boundary of our respect, where we can get the respect, etc. Okay. So again, if you see a trend which is common across all these Vajitas that we have learned so far, is the knowledge is supreme. That is the underlying message that most of the Subhashitas try to convey. Not just knowledge, knowledge and good conduct and good kindness, all these things. These are, again, which, as I said, these are the Atma Gunas, which are very essential to make a person shine. Okay, we shall proceed further.
Adama dhanam icchanti dhano mano tumadhyamaha uttama manam icchanti manohi mahatang dhanam.
Okay, dhanam icchanti, you said dhanam icchanti and dhanamano. So a bit of corrections there. So otherwise, it was well recited. Understand now. Okay, can you identify the kriyapadam, the verbs in this sentence or in this subhashitam?
Icchati.
Icchanti.
Icchati. Icchanti. Yeah.
Right. Okay. Next. Similarly, here also it is icchanti. So these are the two kriyapadams which are there. Can you also identify now the purusha and vachana?
Prathama purusha bahuvachan.
Very good. Prathama purusha
bahuvachanam.
And it is in Parasmaipadi. Icchati, icchataha, icchanti. Okay. Right. So, icchanti. So, what? Kim icchanti? Now, if I ask a question, what will they like? Icchanti.
Dhanam icchanti.
Yes. Dhanam icchanti. Okay. Icchanti. This is Dvitiya Bhakti hi Ekavachanam. Okay. What do they like? This is the object now. Dhanam is become, has become the object. Dhanam icchanti. Okay. Now, who, if you ask a question? Ke dhanam. Adhamaha. Okay, Adhamaha. Bahuvachana Shabda. So since, because of a Visarga Sandhi, it becomes Adhamaha Dhanam Icchanti. But while we write the answer, Adhamaha Dhanam Icchanti. That is how we split this. Okay, so let us see that. Icchati means likes or desires. Okay, and then Adhamaha means inferior people. Okay, people with probably, you can say, probably lesser integrity, etc. So they like or they desire only money. Next, we will go to the second category. So what do Madhyamaha icchanti? Madhyamaha kim icchanti?
Manam.
Dhana manam.
That is right. Dhana manam to Madhyamaha. So you should assume the icchanti is also applicable to this line. Okay. Okay. That's how we make the meaning. Adhamaha dhanam icchanti, madhyamaha tu dhanamano icchanti. So they like not dhana, But there's also the mana, which is respect.
Respect.
Okay, the average people, self-respect. Now, what do Uttamaha, what do the great people like Uttamaha kim icchanti?
Manam
icchanti.
Manam icchanti. Right. Uttamaha manam icchanti. The best people like only the self-respect.
They don't respect. Self-respect.
Money. Money comes or goes, but their self-respect should be intact. That means to say, they will never do anything that is wrong. They will be always ethical. So that is what it means. So based on this observation, the Subhashitakara is telling one line of moral that is nothing but
Manam.
So the mana is the greatest wealth for great people. Mahatam of great people, of great men, or for great people. Mana is the wealth. So this is the meaning of this Subhashitam. Hope it is understood well. So note this. So here, all this, so this Subhashitam portrays the sentence formation correctly, in the sense that what we have learnt so far. We have a Namapadam, that is nothing but the Kartrapadam. We have also a Karmapadam and a Kriyapadam. So what is that? Adhamaha Kartrapadam. Dhanam will become Karmapadam. Icchanti Kriyapadam. Same way, Madhyamaha Dhanamano Icchanti. Then Uttamaha Manam Icchanti. Manohi Mahatam Dhanam. So that mana or the self-respect is the greatest wealth of for great people. Okay, let us go to the next Subhashitam.
Udyamena hi siddhyanti karyanena manorathaihi nahi suktasya simhasya pravishanti mukhe mrigaha.
Mrigaha. Okay, yeah.
Mrigaha. Now let us identify.
Yes. Identify the Kriyapadani in this.
Siddhyanti.
Very good.
Siddhyanti.
Anything else?
Pravishanti.
Very good. Pravishanti and Siddhyanti are the Kriyapadas. Identify the Purusha and Vachana.
Bahuvachan. Pratama Purusha Bahuvachan.
Very good. Same way is also for Pravishanti. Okay. Okay. Now, Kim na Siddhyanti? I ask a question. Now, focus on this first two padas, okay, or the first half of the shloka. Kim na Siddhyanti is the question. Can you identify Kim na Siddhyanti from this? Identify the word that is in Prathama Vibhaktihi. Kim na Siddhyanti is the question. Can you identify which word is in Prathama Vibhakti and can you answer it?
Karyani na Siddhyanti.
Yes, Karyani is Prathama Vibhaktihi Bahuvachanam. Okay, Kim, because I don't know what it is, Kim na Siddhyanti, or Kani na Siddhyanti also, I can ask the question. What will not be successful or what will not be achieved is the question. So Kim na Siddhyanti, Kani na Siddhyanti, Karyani na Siddhyanti. Very good. Katham, I'm asking a question. How? Katham Karyani na Siddhyanti?
Manorathaihi
na Siddhyanti. Manorathaihi Karyani na Siddhyanti. Okay. Now I ask one more question. Karyani katham Siddhyanti? Yes. Katham, how, if you ask a question, or by what, with what, etc. All these will require a word in Tritiya Vibhaktihi as an answer. So the words that are in Tritiya Vibhaktihi in this sentence are Udyamena is in Ekavachanam, and then Manorathaihi is in Bahuvachanam. Okay. So Karyani Udyamena hi Siddhyanti. He means it's a Avyaya, which means only, or you can think that as it's a something that is giving more weightage to it. Udyamena hi Siddhyanti. Only because of Udyama, only because of actions, the Karyani, the tasks can be accomplished. Okay, and not because of just thinking, not just because of Manorathahi. I like to do, but if I don't do, then obviously the task will not be completed. Okay. Now let us see. Udyamaha means effort or hard work or action. You can think it as that way. And next, Siddhyati means is achieved, is accomplished. Karyam means work. Manorathaha means desire. So the tasks or the work is achieved only by effort or hard work and not by just a desire. Okay. For that, this is the statement that the Subhashitakara has given, the moral. And now he is giving an example of this. What is that example? Simhaha. Simhaha means a lion is the king of the jungle. Vanasya Raja. Okay. He is the king of the jungle. If does that mean if he just sits or if he just sleeps, will the prey automatically come into its mouth? That is the question he is asking by giving a beautiful example. Nahi suktasya simhasya pravishanti mukhe mrigaha. So mrigaha, can you identify the vachana and vibhakti for all these words?
Mrigaha is bahuvachana.
Bahuvachanam, very good.
Prathama vibhakti.
Shashti vibhakti hi ekavachanam, very good. Simhasya.
Simhasya shashti vibhakti.
Yes, shashti vibhakti hi ekavachanam, very good. Okay. So suptasya simhasya shashti vibhakti hi ekavachanam. suptasya simhasya mukhe ke na pravishanti. I am asking a question. Suptasya simhasya mukhe ke na pravishanti mrigaha na pravishanti. The mrigaha, the other animals, don't enter into the mukha. Mukha means mouth. Mukhe is saptami bhakti, into the mouth of a lion which is sleeping. That is the meaning of the last two padas. Suptaha simhaha means sleeping lion, and mukham means mouth. Mrigaha means deer or its prey. Pravishati means enters. Pravishanti is bahuvachana of that. So the deers or the preys don't enter the mouth of a sleeping lion. Of a sleeping lion, and hence it is Shashti Vibhakti. The only one Subhashitam which is left, so I will like to complete this today. Okay, the last Subhashitam for the day. Vrittantu sarvatha rakshet vittamayati yati cha nakshino vittataha kshino vrittatastuhato hataha. So to identify in the same way, the kriyapadani are rakshet. Okay. So rakshet is again similar to lalayet, tadayet, etc. In the other subhashitam that we learnt. So that means to say has to be protected. Okay. Vrittam to sarvatha by all means. Sarvatha means by all means. If you remember now, sarvatra we saw a word that means to say everywhere or at all places. Then sarvatha means by all means. Similarly, sarvada, there is one more word which is also an avyaya. Sarvada means at all times, okay? At all places, at all times, etc. These are from the word sarva, which means everything or all. By adding one more suffix to it, which we call basically adhita, etc., which you will learn in future courses. Based on that, the meaning also changes, the overall meaning of that, okay? Next, vittam ayati yati cha. Yati and ayati, opposites, you can know. Gachati, agachati, the same way. Kshinaha, vittataha, kshinaha. Vrittataha, tu, hataha, hataha. So, now let us try to see the meaning of this. Vrittam means good conduct. Shilam, you can also think in that way. Vrittam, sarvatha, by all means. One has to protect his conduct or good conduct by all means. Rakshet, one must protect, okay. Vittam, vittam means dhanam. Ayati comes and goes. Yati cha. The money can come and go. Nakshinaha vittataha kshinaha means if a person has lost some money, if a person has lost some money or weakened with respect to wealth, then he is really not a weakened person. Nakshinaha vittataha kshinaha means a person, if he has lost money, he has not lost anything as such. He is still the same person. But vrittatastu, but with respect to good conduct or with respect to his character, hataha, he will, if the character is lost, if the character is destroyed, even he is equivalent to being killed, or he is also dead, or he is also destroyed. So to recall the quote in English, if wealth is lost, nothing is lost. If health is lost, something is lost. And if character is lost, everything is lost. So that is the gist of this particular Subhashitam. I hope you have understood this. So vrittam to sarvatha rakshit. So hence we will all have to safeguard or protect our character and conduct always. So that is the most important thing. So now you can know how these Subhashitani are there, which are giving so much of good and moral knowledge that we should follow and implement in our lives. So these are the meanings of the Subhashitam. Okay, so with that, we shall conclude today's class. Dhanyavadaha sarvebhyaha. Ram Ram Ram. If there are any other questions, please write an email to me. With that, we shall conclude today's class.